We will continue our journey about 400 years later, joining the Armenians during their forced deportation through the Arabian desert, starting from 1895 and continuing until 1923. Imagine having lived in a country for nearly 3,000 years and then being systematically exterminated by the Ottoman Empire under the pretext that your religion is a threat to Islam. Imagine troops coming into the village and snatching your daughters away from you. Imagine frantically putting mud onto your child's face to make her look dirty and thus less attractive. Imagine seeing your child being raped publicly and then burned alive. And there is absolutely nothing that you can do to save her. See other of your people being beheaded, crucified, tortured, and beaten to death by Ottoman Turkish gendarmes. Imagine losing an entire 2/3 of your country and 2/3 of your people, and being refugees for the rest of your life, having to emigrate from country to another. You are now running for your life, carrying these horrors with you to an unknown future and a world that does not know, does not care, or denies tragedies that you have been through. At the end, 1.5 million Armenians, 1 million Greeks, 1 million Assyrians and others perished during the Ottoman Turkish genocide. Observe your breath. Observe and identify your feelings. What are your feelings at this time? Is it empathy that you feel? Sharing the pain and sorrow will help us get uplifted, and we can uplift others as well. Remember that shared sorrow is half sorrow, and shared joy is double joy. Breathe in for those without breath, and breathe out for your children, your future, and for humankind. Is it gratitude that you feel, giving thanks for the lessons you have learned and showing appreciation for the new meaning you have discovered? Be grateful that you have committed to nonviolence and empathic communication and relations. Breathe in gratitude. Breathe out grace.